Many times in life, one is often troubled by physical pain in addition to emotional trauma. One may be troubled by frequent stomach aches and other illnesses. There may appear no good reason for these to manifest, and yet they persist. Some of these discomforts may appear on and off over a period of several years. Yet there may be no apparent cure for these even after having referred these health issues to medical experts. It is important to understand that mind and body are deeply connected. The subtle form of the body is the mind, or alternately, the grosser mind is what we call the body. Both mind and body are, in a deeper sense, one and the same. The physical discomforts of the body is connected to this truth. Delving deeper, we find that the mind, which is left in an unobserved condition, subsumes within itself a heap of untold illnesses which start manifesting with passage of time, especially accompanying the natural aging process. An unobserved mind is usually a mind that is not submitted for investigation through the spiritual practices of contemplation, concentration, or meditation. Contemplation is the constant review process of the mind's content through intense attention. This contemplation process is to be carried out at fixed times every day. Through contemplation, the content of the mind is understood and the sting of the underlying emotions are harmonized through the power of attention alone. Meditation is a specific process through which attention is managed over the mind and pent-up energy patterns are released through constant practice. Concentration is specific focus of the mind by force in which external objects or abstract ideas are used as the point of focus. Every ailment, from common cold to cancer, prior to its taking a physical form in the body, exists in the form of a thought pattern, a negative vibe, or an undetected toxic emotion that is wedged within the deepest abysses of the mind. When such emotions and behavioral patterns pile up in the mind without being attended to, the mind ejects them out to the grosser level at some point. Thus, the expression of the subtle emotions or toxic thought patterns that have existed as largely unconscious take the form of a disease and manifest in the body. There are studies where it has been found that people who are largely stressed over longer periods and have unmanaged behavior patterns develop cancer during the course of their lives. These observances are empirical by nature. The toxicity embedded within vital organs in the body are in many ways directly proportional to the toxicity within the mind. If people are generally wicked or envious, possibility is that most of them sooner or later shall develop heart problems, sinus, or other diseases which are nothing but the grosser manifestations of these undesirable emotions. Hence, through meditation, one clears off these blocks by continuously spraying the light of attention on the mind. The more one meditates and relaxes one's inherent toxic mentality, the more there will be clarity and open-heartedness. The negative emotions will then not have a place to breed within our system if the mind, which is the repository of emotions, is subjected to the sunlight of meditation and concentration practices. All warmth and happiness will lighten up a mind that is subjected to meditation. A healthy mind will exude energy and enliven a healthy body. If meditation becomes the language of the mind, then health shall become the song of the body.